Welcome back to another cookie tips video. I wanted to address some of the questions I get about the bags I use. I use tipless bags and a lot of people don't know the advantages of using them, so I thought I'd go over it in this video today. Let's get into it. Bags is basically, they're basically a piping bag that you do not need those metal tips to be able to pipe with. It's normally a thinner plastic than the ones you would find, let's say the Wilton bags that you find at the craft stores, the disposable bags. So what's the purpose of a tipless bag? Well, you don't have to use tips, therefore you don't have to clean tips, and you also have the flexibility of cutting the tip to the size that you want. Do you want a thicker tip, a thinner tip? It really depends on how big you cut the tip. So that way you don't have to have, 500 tips in your house, metal tips of each size, especially when you're doing cookies. You're using a lot of the same size holes for your bags. And so instead of buying, 10 tips in each size, 1, 2, 3 that you need, you can just cut all your bags to size. If you need it a little bit bigger because your icing's thicker or thinner, you need a smaller tip, you can really customize it any way you'd like. So just as I would fill any piping bag, I like to put mine over a tall glass and then open it up and fold it over the glass. This helps me have the bag open while I'm filling it up with my icing. So what you can do with these bags, once you've filled them up, if you haven't filled them up too much, I actually like to tie knots in the bags. Or if your bag is a little bit too full and you don't have enough space to tie a knot, I just like to use these clips. A lot of cookiers sell them now as well with their tipless bags, but these ones are just cheap ones I've gotten from IKEA that I have a bunch of, and they always come in handy to close your bags if you can't tie a knot into them. So how exactly do you cut a tip? Well, the first thing is you usually only have one seam in your bag. You want that seam in the middle. You want to flatten the tip of your bag as much as possible and try to get it all the icing out of there so you can have a nice clean cut. You always want to start as small as possible and have a nice sharp pair of scissors to make your cut. So you can see here I cut a tiny, tiny hole and my lines are really small. You can see I have full control over my bag. It's not curling. The icing's coming out nicely. Depending on how much pressure I put on the bag, it comes out either faster or slower, thicker. Now let's say, if that's a little bit too thin for me to do my outline or some of my details, I can always cut a bigger hole. So again, you want the seam in the middle. Now that I have a hole, it's a little bit easier to flatten out. And again, I'm just cutting a tiny bit bigger. And so now I have a little bit of a thicker hole. And again, start small and you can always cut it bigger. I mean, if you go too big, you basically have to re-bag your icing, put it in a new bag and start again. So now to show you guys what it would look like once I pipe. So here, if you want a ruffled look or a ribbon look, this is a great way to do it if you don't have the correct tip. Okay, now I'll show you guys another little trick you can do with a tipless bag. So here, I'm gonna cut the bag at an angle, again with really sharp scissors, and you can see that one side will be a little bit bigger than the other side. So depending which way you hold the bag, whether you have your bigger opening up top, or if you flip the bag the other way and you have the bigger opening, you can see they're just little ruffles, the way it comes out, kinda makes a nice little ruffle edge. So here, after I have my stem, I'm gonna just do a few almost semicircles here. And this is just like a really rough cookie to show you guys what you can do with one tipless bag, or I guess two tipless bags because it's two different colors, but it gives you the idea of just using tipless bags without having the actual tips. So now I'm gonna go back to my green bag and I'll show you how to make a leaf tip. So here again, I flatten my tip out and I'm basically going to cut in an upside down V. So you want the point of the V facing away from you. Again, you want really sharp scissors. You try to make it as even as possible. And so you can see I'm just using the seam as a guideline to try to get my point to it. And so I'll go ahead and show you guys what it looks like when you pipe this on a cookie. And here I'm just using a paper towel as an example. So depending how much pressure you put, the more pressure you put, the bigger the leaf will be, the less pressure, the smaller, you can wiggle it up and down and so on and so forth. And so like again, with the same tip or piping bag, we've cut a different tip. So here I'm just gonna add a few leaves just to show you, again, just a rough cookie here to show you all the options you have when using tipless bags. It also gives you a lot of control over, you know, how much icing is coming out of your bag. If your icing is, you know, a medium consistency, so not too thick or too thin, and you put a lot of pressure, you can build up that icing and make a puffier section, or, you know, the flood comes out faster. Because it's a thinner plastic, it's almost, you know, it gives a little bit with the pressure you put on the bag. And if you want to really control your icing and do fine lines and have a really small area to do, you don't have to put too much pressure on it, and it comes out, you know, really slowly. And so you can really work with a bag, and when you get used to it, you can do a lot of different things. You can pressure pipe and, you know, do letters and do make different types of leaves and greenery. And I personally like to use large bags. I always order the largest size bag I can, like a 10-inch bag or a 12-inch bag, because if I need to flood a lot of cookies, I like to fill my bags up a lot so I'm not using so many bags. And if it's just, if I need a little bit of icing, I can still use the same bag, and I usually just cut it down so I don't have so much excess hanging off. But I do like to tie my bags as well. I find it keeps the icing in there better than the clips, and so the larger the bags, it gives me a lot of excess there to be able to tie the bags. Well, I hope you guys found that informative, and as always, thank you guys so much for watching and supporting my channel. And I'm looking forward to teaching you guys more tips and tricks about cookies. Happy baking!